So in this class we will discuss about the reciprocal lattice. As I mentioned, the diffraction spot, basically if I tell love spot, so on a photographic plate, so they shows the symmetry of the crystal. So these love spots are on the photographic plate. They have some symmetry as a similar type of arrangement of love spot to the direct lattice. In case of direct lattice, whatever the lattice point are arranged, so in photographic plate, the love spots are also arranged with some order, okay. And each point is basically considered as a point for a plane. So planes of real crystal are converted into points on diffraction space. So that is basically is called the K space also, that I will discuss later on. So so that space where we can think of similar type of lattice, as we have seen space lattice. So in diffraction space also there, so that's we can get that type of arrangement of points where each point will represent the plane of crystal. So that planes or that lattice is basically called reciprocal lattice. So why it is called reciprocal lattice and how it is important, that basically we will discuss in this class. So, so we have say A1, A2, A3 axis in space lattice or Brevis lattice or in real crystal. So earlier I used ABC, but now I am using them as A1, A2, A3 because I have to set another axis system. So this A1, A2, A3 in space lattice, they are, if it is this A1, this is A2 and this is A3 in space lattice. So they will form a unit cell. They will form a unit cell. I need space. So So these two has to be parallel. It's more or less okay. Yeah, so this more or less it is done, but it's not perfect one anyway. So this is the unit cell, it's maybe triclinic unit cell. So here if I define another set of axis, say B1, B2, B3. Okay. So this definition, if it is like that, the B1, let me write B3 first. B3 equal to A cross A1 cross A2, A1 cross A2 by volume of this unit cell. Okay. So, what does it mean? What is the relation between this A1, A2, A3 axis and B1, B2, B3 axis? If we define the axis, relation between this axis like this. Okay. So, you can see this B3 is, so what is A1, A2? A1 cross A2. So, this is the area, this is the area of this plane, right. So, this is the area of this plane, area, this represent area. Okay. I think this is basically area. Okay. Now what is the volume then? So, if it is area and this direction of this will be that B3 direction. So, it will be normal, B3 will be normal to A1 and A2, right, because this A cross A1 cross B2. So, the direction will be the normal to the to this plane. Okay. So, if B3 is equal to this, then this B3 direction will be normal to this plane. So, let us draw the normal to this plane. Okay. So, this is the normal, this is the direction of B3. So, this is B3 direction, right. So, from the definition we can get the direction of B3. And what is the magnitude of this B3, that let us check. So, what is volume? Volume is basically V equal to V equal to, I can write this area into height, that will be the volume of this unit cell, right. Area of this one into multiplied with this height, so that will be the volume. So, just here we are writing this area, area of what I can define, say if it is O, O it is A, it is B and it is C, okay. So, area of O A B C, area of O B C, area of O A B C, right, into height, height of this unit cell, right. So, what will be the height of the unit cell? So, this so the height of the unit cell will be, if you just take this projection of this A3 on this normal, okay, so that will be the height, that will be the height. So, so this height, if it is say P, so height will be OP. So, area into height OP, right. So, B3 is basically, you can write B3 equal to, or magnitude of B3, magnitude of B3, magnitude of B3 will be, so this, this area, area, area of O A B C, O A B C divided by area of O A B C into O P. Right, height is OP, into OP. So, you are getting basically this one equal to, this one equal to 1 by OP, right. You are getting 1 by OP. So, so what is OP? OP is basically height of this unit cell, and it is and this it is also basically normal to this plane OABC, and it is along the B3 direction. So, this, so this direction, this this is basically height of which plane? If you see this, this, this is the plane, this is the parallel plane of this one, this is the parallel plane of this one, right. So, so which plane it is? It is, it is as if 0 0 1 plane, right, 0 0 1 plane, this is 0 0 1 plane, and this height, the 0 0 1 plane, and this height whatever, this is nothing but the spacing between this spacing, that spacing between these two planes, right. So, distance between these two planes, right. So, that is nothing but the planar distance. So, this OP is basically planar distance of 0 0 1 plane. So, this is one plane, and distance from this plane to this plane, they are parallel plane, so that the lattice spacing basically. So this OP is nothing but its planar spacing of 0 0 1, right. So B3 I got its magnitude of B3 is got this D 0 1 1. So similarly, you can show that in case of B1, in case of say B2. So that will be the planar spacing, that magnitude will be planar spacing of this parallel to this cut this B axis. So which one? This is A axis, these two A axis, and B axis will be this, okay. It's this plane, okay. And another plane is this, so that will be distance between these two planes. So same way you can write D 010 and B1 will be 1 by D 100, right. So just we have derived one. From here, the same way one can see that's the magnitude of B1, B2, B3. Okay, so we defined vectors this 3-axis like this. So this will be A3 cross A1 by volume, right, and other one will be B1 will be equal to A2 cross A3 by volume, right. So A1, A2, A3, this is the axis for real crystal for space lattice, right. So now I defined 3 more axes, B1, B2, B3, taking this definition, right. So if I take this definition, then what I see that this, the magnitude of this B1, B2, B3 is nothing but the reciprocal of the planar spacing, right. So these 3 axes, it is basically reciprocal of some planar spacing. So now using this B1, B2, B3, using this axis, if we produce points, lattice points, okay, then it will form a lattice. If we produce many points in point, so it will form a lattice. So that lattice is basically called the reciprocal lattice, right. Taking this A1, A2, A3, these 3 axes, we can just using translational vector, right, we can produce points in space, okay. So they are lattice point of space lattice, right. So what translation vector we use? So T equal to U A 1 plus V A 2 plus W A 3, right. So earlier I used A 1, A, B, C, now just A 1, A 2, A 3, just I mentioned earlier. So this, using this translation vector, we can produce all lattice points, right. Similarly, using this axis, we can produce points in space, okay. So it will give another lattice, and this that lattice is different from this lattice, and that lattice is called reciprocal lattice, right. So for this also we need translational type of vector. So this we tell, this is called reciprocal vector. It's not translation vector, but it's similar. It's this reciprocal vector. Say if it is H, then we can write H B 1 plus K B 2 plus L B 3, right, similar to this, right. Here I have considered H K L as a coordinate, right. So here whatever U V W, so here H K L. So this H K L is same as the Miller indices. This H K L are the basically H K L are Miller indices. Okay. So why should I take the this HKL, right? So we can show that this is nothing but Miller indices. Okay, I can take other say PQR other coordinate, but the PQR later on we can show that it's nothing but it is Miller indices. So directly I have written as a Miller. I have used Miller indices, so you will find out later on. So, but one can guess also that, so from here you are seeing that basically direction is the this B 1 direction, B 2 direction, B 3 direction, it is the directions are, in this case it will be it will not be along the A 1 axis, yeah. So, that I cannot say, but if you take orthogonal axis system like cubic, orthorhombic and tetragonal, where this axis are orthogonal, A 1, A 2, A 3 are orthogonal, then we can show that B 1, B 2, B 3 also they are orthogonal. And A 1 will be parallel to B 1, A 2 will be parallel to B 2, and A 3 will be parallel to B 3. Okay. So this is the reciprocal vector. We tell this reciprocal vector, we define like this, where H, K, L are Miller indices. So not necessary to take directly Miller indices, other parameter also we can take, but ultimately we will see later on that they will be nothing but the Miller indices, right. So now important fact is that So from here you can see that B1 is the direction, B1 direction is perpendicular. This is the perpendicular symbol, right? This is a B1 is perpendicular to this plane. So on this plane, A2 and A3 vectors are there. So if B1 is perpendicular on this plane, so it is perpendicular to A2 as well as A3, right? So B1 is perpendicular to A2 and A3. Right, A2 and A3, then B2 is perpendicular to on this plane, right? So it is perpendicular to A1 and A3, right? And B3 is perpendicular to A1 and A2, right. So this axis are perpendicular to the, these are axis are perpendicular to the, so the axis of real crystal, and then we can see that if they are perpendicular, so we can get some relation that B1 dot A1 I cannot say, but I can say B1 dot A2 equal to B1 dot product basically is 0, right. Similarly, B2 dot A1 equal to B2 dot A3 equal to 0. B3 dot A1 equal to B3 dot A2 equal to 0, right. So in general I can say AM dot BN equal to 0, when M is not equal to N, right? When M is not equal to N. What about the other one? This, when this M and N are same, like B1 A1 dot A1, B2 dot A2, B3 dot A3. So what about that one? So this, say if I take B3 dot A3, B3 dot A3, okay. So what will be that? So B3 is basically B3 is magnitude along this axis, B3 axis, right, and magnitude is what is 1 by d 0, sorry this I did mistake, so it will be 0, B3 will be 0 0 1, yes. So it is B3 magnitude is 1 by d 0 0 1. 1 by d 0 0 1 is nothing but OP, right, it is nothing but this OP, magnitude OP, right. And so this, so here I will not this, so basically magnitude of B3 and magnitude of A3, then this cos some angle between these two. Angle between these two, right. So if I take the magnitude of B3, that is OP, and now the unit vector along this B3. Now, if you take the dot product of this A3 on this unit vector along this direction, so that is basically projection of A3, right, projection of A3 on this. So, this dot product is basically this OP, then magnitude of this one and the projection of this. So, projection of A3 along this direction. So, projection of A3 along this direction, what is that? It is so, this projection of this will be basically I can, so this A3, so this will be OP, okay, so I did mistake, so B3, magnitude of B3 is, magnitude of B3 is 1 by OP, so I have erased it, so it is 1 by OP, because OP is this D 0 0 1, right, D 0 0 1. So, this will be 1 by OP, OP is D 0 0 1, right. So, into the projection of A3 along this direction, that is projection of this three along this direction is OP. So, this basically equal to 1 by OP into OP, so is equal to 1, okay. So I can write that this B3 dot A3, that is 1, similarly one can show A1 dot B1, A2 dot B1, A2 dot B2 will be equal to 1. So, this will be equal to 1 when m equal to n. So, this is very important relation and which follows the reciprocal, which follows the reciprocal lattice in connection with the space lattice, okay. So here whatever we have done, so we have defined access system B1, B2, B3, okay. So, this is the access system of reciprocal lattice, okay. Why it is reciprocal, as I defined, because this reciprocal lattice, this access system are related with the planar spacing of the space lattice, and their relation is inverse, is reciprocal with each other. So, that is why it is reciprocal, and relation between the axis system of both, they follow this, and also this translation vector can produce the space lattice, space point. Similarly, this reciprocal vector, this is the reciprocal vector, it can produce the similar lattice, which is basically reciprocal lattice. So I will stop here. So I'll continue in next class. Thank you for your attention.